2019 will flow into 2020 in spite of, well, the toxicity and the White House misadventures. America will recover. I know this because of people like ourselves. I know this because of who we meet on Democratic Visions, a simple local community access series. Again, this year, without crosstalk or bull hockey, Tim O'Brien and others like Nancy Nelson and myself listened.
Well, it will be.
We're about to sample what went on here this past year and mix in a new commentary by Howard Lieberman, a song by Dave Dvorak, and two wonderful music videos. We begin with Tim and Minnesota Secretary of State Steve Simon.
Well, it's got to be very gratifying as someone in your position to see that number one ranking is restored.
Yes.
And I suspect that's recognized across the country, isn't it?
It is.
Something that people want to emulate?
It is. So I have occasion to see my colleagues from around this country, other secretaries of state and others in the election space. Mm-hmm. And I can't tell you how many times one of them has come up to me and said, I wish we were like Minnesota in this way, or how the heck did you get that law passed, or how can we do what you're doing? So we have a culture that is imitated and emulated across the country, but we got to stay sharp, and we can't just sit back and rest on our past success. We got to stay restless about this stuff.
We're going to do it again this fall. It looks like there'll be even more collaborators, and in between times, we're working with city officials, with the police. We're moving to make sure that from now on, there's going to be less and less violence in the Twin Cities. And one of the biggest obstacles to that is the belief, the assumption by most people, that the way to prevent wrongdoing, the way to prevent violence, is by violence, by punishment. So our biggest challenge is to help people to see that doesn't work. You know, in our prisons in the United States and throughout the world, 85% of the people who go to prison come back because punishment doesn't work.
There's so much. You just need the two books, okay? Think and Live Differently, Maverick Priest. It'll help. Trust me. In 2018, actually, you began in 2017.
But there is so much content online and in the world that I don't know how mad can make a lot of noise anymore. I mean, maybe that's a bad way to feel about it.
What kind of dirge music would you choose when that time comes when it's officially no longer a rerun? Dirge music, funeral music, would you choose?
Oh, you know, Chopin, Dennis says Chopin.
Chopin?
That's my agent,
okay.
Chopin.
Yeah,
yes,
okay.
Yes.
This spotlight edition of Democratic Visions begins in East Africa. Earlier this year, students and school officials in Kifungilo, Tanzania, welcomed author Maria Nambu and her friends Catherine Mahmer and Jackie Masio with dance and music. The Minnesotans were returning to Kifungilo to mark the completion of Maria Nambu's memoir, The Dancing Soul Trilogy. The Kifungilo area was Maria Nambu's childhood home.
She had come back from a trip to Africa, and she said, now's the time to start writing the book. This is about 25 years ago.
She wanted to celebrate that she had finished this trilogy of books, and she would like to introduce them in Tanzania.
We have three visitors from America.
I remember the first time somebody told me I was black. I actually went into a mirror and looked at myself, and I absolutely did not see a black person. I saw me.
What came out of the legislature to address, I should say, the problems that we've witnessed all over the country as far as mass shootings are concerned, and as you and I would know, could happen in Hennepin County, Ramsey County, the state of Minnesota very easily. Anything, any movement in the legislature on guns this last session?
No, actually, I think it went backwards because the GOP in the Senate continues to block the conversation about it. Just this past few weeks when we met at the Minnesota State Fair, I bumped into Senator Gazelka, and he was telling me how we're one of the top 10 most restrictive states when it comes to gun laws. Well, we might be one of the most restrictive under his guise, but the reality is people are dying because they can get a gun pretty easily without a background check, and they can get a gun with some issues of mental health that we have to tackle. It's not just about guns, but it's also what the resources we put in to our health system in Minnesota.
Then the woman came again to my house and knocked the door. She said, Osman is here. Is he came from America, right? Yes, he came from America. Is he okay?
Our boys, Samson and Mahmoud, met playing soccer at school.
You're a storyteller yourself.
I am.
Yeah. Why are you enthusiastic about this? It's not a sport, it's not a hobby. What do you call it?
It's the way we understand ourselves and the world we live in. You know, there's another writer who said, the world isn't made of atoms, it's made of stories.
And then there's Sid Hartman. Gelfand, you son of a bitch, you went too far this time.
Excuse me. Did you have a question about the Hall of Fame?
You know, I'm just wondering what a broadcasting giant would have to do to become a part of this.
Oh, sure, yeah. Well, you need to be nominated.
What?
You need to be nominated to the Hall of Fame.
Oh, sure, you put up
and
all these huge roadblocks.
There's a committee that votes on that. And,
sure. Yeah. I see a lot of giants of the industry here.
Sure.
But then I notice there's an omission or two.
What do you think?
What if we just sort of expedited the process?
Ooh, well, let's, what do you think? Let's talk this over.
Huh? That might help, huh? I mean, you look like a pretty reasonable guy.
Yeah, what do you have in mind?
Well, I mean, I brought this picture.
Okay.
It's pretty nice, huh?
That looks to be about the right size.
Yeah, well, right. And I was thinking maybe we could just, let's just say we did a quick swap here. Maybe right here. What do you think? Huh?
I think we might have to take a vote on that, too. We'll get the committee together.
Who would have to vote?
The most interesting.
You know, the one I've been arguing on behalf for my entire 3 years in the Senate is requiring American government in high school. It's not required right now, and I've been working on that pretty hard. And I finally made it through committee this year, and it passed the House and the Senate, but it's not required. It's encouraged.
I see.
So that's, I got baby steps, right? Okay.
Let's start with guns. Is that an issue in 51B?
It's absolutely an issue. I think it's an issue statewide. It's something that everybody seems to be talking about. I think the conversation has changed a lot over the years as we've seen some of these tragedies play out in our communities. And it's become very clear that public policy could make a real difference and prevent some of the tragedies that we've seen. And the House of Representatives this year did pass two bills that are some of the most popular bills when it comes to preventing gun violence.
The peace and quiet of being able to come here and almost completely forget that you're even in the middle of a big metro area.
The trail would let bikers rip through protected areas with pristine big woods and an endangered bumblebee, and would betray decades of Minnetonka stewardship.
I think this is the most beautiful park that we have in this area. My first walks are very early in the morning, so I get to see the ecosystem at its best.
My thought about this whole thing is that this issue is not really about mountain biking. It's really about who we are as a people and what our vision for the future is and how we treat the land.
We would like to see this park keep the big woods, maybe put it under the protection of a land trust so that it is considered officially a big woods remnant.
Let's talk a moment about anti-Semitism and Israel. I'm a lefty liberal, devoutly agnostic, anti-religious Jew. and I'm afraid today. Anti-Semitism is rampant. A lot of my friends go, yeah, it's those right-wingers, those skinheads, those neo-Nazis. Yeah, look at that horrible anti-Semitism. But to those people, my friends, I say, and it's rampant on the left as well. These are my people, the lefties, I mean. For all of you on the left who say, I'm not anti-Semitic, I'm anti-Israel. Really? Are you anti-North Korea? Are you anti-Sudan? Are you anti-Egypt? Are you anti-Syria? If the only country about which you rail constantly is Israel, I suggest that you look in the mirror and ask yourself, is that an anti-Semite looking back at me? Now, is everything that Israel does perfect? No. Is everything that this country does, or any country in the world, perfect? No. Israel is a democracy. And yes, Palestinians, Muslims, Catholics, people of all faiths have rights to be equal citizens in the state of Israel, where people of all faiths, all colors, all backgrounds have a right to vote. There's a country in the Middle East where women have led the country, are the doctors, are the lawyers, are the college professors, in far greater numbers than in our grand democracy, and that country is Israel. Name one country, one Muslim-dominant country that could say the same thing. When you come into the old city, you hear the minarets calling the Muslim worshipers to prayer. How many synagogues, how many churches in Muslim-dominant countries do you believe exist and welcome their Jewish and Christian and Hindu brothers and sisters? I would say zero, not one. I don't know why the left hates Jews as much as they do, but they do. I understand the right, that's that nativist anti-Semitism stuff, we're the people who killed Christ or whatever we supposedly did. But to the left, we're privileged white people who own Hollywood, who own banks, who own the newspapers, who control the minds and hearts of people through our Benjamins. Might that be anti-Semitic? That offends me. I can't handle the right. I can't influence the right. Are they anti-Semitic? Hell yes. You're my brothers and sisters on the left. You, I'm willing to debate. Make no mistake, I'm devoutly agnostic, I'm anti-religious, and I'm left-wing, but I am, above all else, a Jew. And if you attack Israel, you attack me.
Last May, my pal Ahmed Thurwad and I were on the North Shore for a weekend of ruminating, bird watching, horsing around, and the Duluth Dylan Fest. Ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. Our friends Jerry Esnough and Dave Dvorak and other folkies were giving the concert inspired by native son Bob Dylan. Here's some of Jerry and then Dave.
Well, she talks to all the servants about man and God and law. Everybody knows she is the brains behind Pa. She's 68, says she's 24. Ain't gonna work for Maggie's mind.
Second time with us. He says he's been writing songs for about 7 years and he figures there's no more fitting place to come and sing his original songs than here in the birthplace of Bob. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Dave Dvorak.
This is a song I wrote. It's called Another Song About Rain. The heavens cry upon the earth like an overflowing cup. The rain, it slaps my windshield. My wipers can't keep up. I know my trunk is empty, but I carry such a load. I'm trying to find myself again, my headlights try to find the road. It's time to get accustomed to being on my own. It's time to redefine all the things I knew as home. I have no clue what lies ahead, but I've seen what lies behind. How the rain keeps falling harder, and you know I really don't know. I wonder if these clouds will ever clear. Here's a man drowning in his sorrow. Here's a man swimming in his pain. Here's a man trying to make it to tomorrow. So here's another song about rain. Now I see my kid on weekends, and we fill the time at hand. I tell him that I love him, and I pray he'll understand. I take him out for ice cream, he mostly seems alright. He still likes to hear my stories as I tuck him in.
Dave Dvorak is also with the Twin Cities band Zoe Says Go. The group's first album, Space Between the Notes, is trending on college radio stations, and Mr. Esnough has a supporting role in Zoe's retro video, Road Trip. It's a lark.
Jerry, Road Trip. The band's going on a road trip. Let's get out of this disaster.
I got all these files, man.
This? You know what this is, Jerry? This stack of files? This is regret. Come on, road trip. I'll be at the bar waiting for the van. Last chance, Jerry.
Check the oils. Come on, come on, come on, let's take a road trip. Come on, come on, come on, let's take a road trip. Come on, come on, come on, let's take a road trip. 'Cause there's so many places that you and I can go. Just roll down your window, turn up the radio. Limits fade away in our rearview mirror. Like all of our troubles, they just get smaller and soon they disappear. So let your hair down, buckle right up, kick off your shoes. Forest and fields, mountains and plains, man, let's enjoy those views. There's no traffic in sight, we're on cruise control. There ain't no sign of state control. This highway stretches to infinity, like my when you're next to me. So come on, come on, come on, let's take a road trip. Come on, come on, come on, let's take a road trip.
Thanks for staying with us. The Democratic team wishes you a delightful holiday season and a fine new year. And remember, do good work. Now, before we go, a new version of We Are the World was released a year and a half ago in New York by a group called Broadway United. The video features an all-star roster of theater artists calling for healing and unity throughout the world.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call,
when the world must come together as one.
There are people dying, and it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all.
God's great big family, and the truth, you know, love is all we need.
We are the world, we are the children, we are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving. There's a choice we're making, we're saving our own lives. It's true.
Their lives will be stronger and free.
As God has shown us by turning stone to bread, so we all must lend a helping hand.
We are the world, we are the children.
our own lives.
It's true, we'll make a better day, just you and me.
Democratic Visions is handcrafted by volunteers from Eden Prairie, Edina, Minnetonka, Hopkins, and Bloomington. Watch us on select community access channels and on YouTube. This is Carol Sundstrom.